Welcome back to 6 Mile Outdoors. I'm Bobby Harris. Hey, we got an exciting day today. I've got a new toy that came in, and right now we're just sitting at the bench here. I've got a shooting bench set up at the back door of my shop. When I built this place, I pushed a berm of dirt up about 100 yards away down by the creek, and I've got it set up so I can, if I need to, I can just shoot right from the back door here. Got my reloading bench right here behind me, so if I need to do some custom load work, I can just set up here and shoot out the back door, and it's all safe going that way. But I've got this set up for a number of reasons here, but we're going to be shooting a couple of guns today. First off, we're going to shoot a few rounds through this custom 22 that I built. It's just a Thompson Center 22 that they no longer make anymore, but what I did was I Cerakoted all the metal in Patriot Brown, and then I hydro dipped this Vail camo on the scope and the stock. And so that's just kind of a few little touches I did for myself on that gun. And we're also gonna be shooting my custom 308. So this one's suppressed and it's had some work done to the barrel, some fluting, work done to the bolt and other things, but I've got that in Kuyu camo with a tungsten gray Cerakote on everything. We're going to shoot both of these guns just really not to do much of anything as far as load development, but we're going to be testing a new toy. And so today came in the new Garmin Chronograph. And so you've probably seen these on the internet. People are testing them now. They're really hard to get a hold of. I happen to have found one and got it in. It's we're still here in rifle season in Oklahoma, so I was lucky enough to fill my tag the first day, so now I'm just playing with toys. So I've got time to really play with this and kind of see what it does, but I wanted you guys to see kind of the first look and everything about it. I'm not going to do an unboxing video. You can already tell I've got it out, but you see those on the internet. I'm not real fans of unboxing. I'm more fans of how does this thing work. So what we're going to do is set up here. We're going to use it on the rimfire. And so it's got two selections in here. You can set up for rifles that are like, I believe it was 600 feet per second to 1700, and then 1700 to 5000. So you have to pick that. So right now I've got it set up, of course, on the lesser of the two. And we're going to shoot the 22 right off the bat here. Like I said, I've only got a target about 50 yards down here. So we're not really shooting for groups or anything. We're just shooting to test this and see how well it picks up. Now, for those that are unfamiliar with this product, this is pretty unique. You can see it's only about the size of a GoPro camera, and it's rather unique. But what makes this unique and really a hot item right now, you know, it was really hard to find one of these. I looked for about 3 or 4 weeks before I really located one. But this is a Doppler radar chronograph. So it's not like the old chronograph you see in the archery store that is just a light driven chronograph that they shoot the arrow through. Those are a little hard to get to operate on cloudy days and things. And the reason we're set up in the shop right now is it's raining outside. It's not really a heavy rain. We just have a mist going on and all that. I just didn't feel like setting up outside and getting wet. So we're doing this from the shop. So nonetheless, I thought I'd kind of show you where we're at, but this thing, what makes it unique is, I don't know if you've ever seen a lab radar, but those things are, you know, about this big a square. They work great for what they are. This is the same concept, only in a package this size. You can take it to the range with you. You can set up everything and, you know, carry it in your pocket, whatever it takes. This little tripod that comes with it actually flips out into legs, and so you can set it on your bench. And even though it's hard plastic, it's got little rubber feet on the bottom, so it kind of stays put in its place. And so the menu setup and the functionality is extremely easy on this. I would show you what it looks like on the phone, but I'm actually recording this on my phone. So there is an app that you can download that stores all the data straight to the phone. So as the shots are being fired, it's keeping a history on your phone and on this unit. So anyway, we're going to be able to see that. But right now, as you can see, it's got a number of features here that you may or may not be able to read, but it gives you your your current shot, of course, and where those dotted lines are. And it also gives you the minimum shot, or the shot that was the slowest and the shot that was the fastest. And then in the middle, it gives you your average speed. So what we're going to do is fire 10 shots from the 22, and then we're going to switch over and shoot the 308, three or four shots out of the 308, just to kind of test the chronograph, see how that operates. But in the meantime, what I'm going to do is reset up the camera so you're able to kind of see what I'm doing downrange, as opposed to just... All right, herein lies the challenge. We've got the chronograph set up, and it's, of course, projecting the Doppler radar downrange. You have to have this set up within 5 to 15 inches behind the muzzle of the gun, as well as 5 to 15 inches next to the barrel itself. So we're going to test this and see how well it picks up. One concern I have is, of course, setting it up here and projecting against this door frame. And, you know, are we going to get a good read downrange? I've heard it's very accurate and that we can. I've seen guys shooting these on video at PRS matches with people on either side and still able to only pick up your shot. So we're going to test this and find out. So I've already got a few rounds loaded up here. What we're going to do is just fire continuously, you know, just to see how well it tracks and keeps track of all the readings. So we'll get started here. Since I'm adjusting everything, I should have probably done this before, but now I'm going to move this so that it is still behind the muzzle. I shot two real quick just to see if it would pick up two, and of course I didn't, so I'll shoot the next one. So I need to slow down and give it time between shots. So that's the last shot. Now, you saw that was kind of, in my opinion, kind of all over the place, but I am, out of fairness, I am shooting some very old ammo. I think some of this ammo that I have is actually from the late 80s, maybe early 90s, that I had found, I stuck back in the back of the closet. So I thought, well, I'll just use that for plinking ammo. So there was quite a wide variation from 1,079 feet per second all the way up to 1,283. And it was just standard lead tipped, you know, out of the box ammo that was marked 99 cents a box. So you can kind of get an idea of just how old that ammo is, but did real well with this one. And so I'm kind of pleased with how well it picked up. Of course, you saw the first two shots I shot back to back, and it didn't seem to like that. So you've got to give it a little bit of time to reset. So anyway, I'll jump off here, get everything reset, and we'll go through the 308. All right, we're back with the 308 all set up and ready to go. So I'll kind of show you what it takes to get through a new session here. What I'm going to do is, of course, put in the new session, rifle. Now I'm going to toggle to the faster Whoops, it was already on the faster speed. And I'm going to go ahead and enter my ballistic weight. You don't have to enter your ballistic weight, but I'm going to do that anyway, just to show you what it is. And we are shooting 168 grain ELD match grade bullets. So once again, it tells you 5 to 15 inches behind the muzzle and 5 to 15 inches to the side of the muzzle. And now it's ready to go. So since this barrel's longer, we're going to put it up here just a little bit farther. Get it aimed towards the target. And it will, of course, get the Doppler radar going. So we'll kick about 3 shots down range, but since this is suppressed and it's really easy on the ears. However, inside this area with, you know, under the awning and all of that stuff, I'm probably still going to get a lot of feedback. So I am wearing hearing protection as well as shooting suppressed. Here we go. I know you can't see it, but that was a tight group. Let's check to see what this does here. This says, let's see, our minimum was 2548. So the last shot was the minimum. And our maximum was 2606. And 2575 was our average. So I'm going to see what I set this up for, because I calculated an average speed on this earlier. And I actually have my turret set up to be, I have a custom turret on this gun that is designed for this particular load, and I've got it set up at 2552, so we're in the ballpark. We've got 2575 is my average speed, so we're in the ballpark of being, you know, what that particular turret is set up for. Now, that's good. That's one of the things I wanted to check, but what I'm going to do now is start working backwards from everything that I've done here, just so that I can work into a load that matches my turret and try to get that done. So that's a good thing about this. That way, you know, you can kind of back into where you need to be. If you've got a particular set of ammo that's shooting real well, such as these are, you can't see it, but those that's just a cloverleaf group down there. Of course, it's only 50 yards, so it should be. But regardless, it's a good group. So if you found one that's shooting right, you can see what it does and then work your loads down to back into that working. So it's just something that, you know, if you find the thing you like that works, then, you know, that'll help you recreate it, let's say. So anyway, I just wanted to bring that to you guys. I wanted to kind of show you what that is, what it does. And you can see I moved it, and it doesn't like to be moved once the Doppler is running. But you can use it on your archery equipment as well. That was one of the reasons that I purchased it, is because it's pretty versatile. The setup shows that you can do archery, air rifle, you can do airsoft guns, things like that. But you have to kind of tell it what you're doing, so it's kind of prepared for that. If you're doing archery, you have to shoot like within 6 to 12 inches over the top of this, and you'll see a black line on the top. That's where you should shoot over the top of the unit, and you have to shoot a minimum of 20 yards. So your target, whether you're shooting guns or whatever, has to be at least 20 yards away just for it to have time to pick it up and do its calculations. So anyway, I think this is definitely worth the money. They're very hard to find right now. They're starting to get back on the market, but some places are still showing that they're not going to have stock back in until January. And so that'll be a while for some of the guys to wait. But regardless, if you're watching every day and you look, you'll be able to find one of these probably before Christmas. So anyway, I wanted to bring that to you and kind of show you what this neat little thing does. And you'll be seeing more of this as we move forward and work on more load development. All right. Well, guys, I appreciate it. Have a great Thanksgiving, and everybody be safe. God bless.